break it down. 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 Go. 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 Go.
The higher you build your barriers.
Charter School. It is Tuesday, May 5th. Welcome to another Morning Circle with Baba Mark. Let's all stand in a strong angalaya and get ready for the pouring of libations. We're standing in a strong angalaya, and as always, we do have permission from our elder, Dr. Mama, to begin. And to that, we say Ashe. We pour libations to the gift of life and learning. Ashe. To laughter and love. Ashe. We pour libations to the energy that woke us up this morning. Ashe. To the cradle of civilization. Ashe. Africa. Ashe. To the cradle of civilization that gave us things like arithmetic. Ashe. Scripture. Agriculture. Architecture. Ashe. We pour libations to the kingdoms that we are named after, Ashe. Zulu, Ashe. Songhai, Ashe. Kush, Ashe. Congo, Ashe. Yoruba, Ashe. And Maasai, Ashe. We pour libations to the kings and queens of these nations, Ashe. Like Sunny Ali, Ashe. Mansa Musa, Ashe. Queen Nzinga, Ashe. Queen Nefertiti, Ashe. We pour libations to the freedom fighters of these nations, Ashe. Patrice Lumumba, Ashe. Nelson Mandela, Ashe. Winnie Mandela, Ashe. And we pour libations to those who left the continent of Africa willingly, Ashe. Those who gave birth to humanity across the world, Ashe, and crossed the seas and the mountains and in the valleys in order to populate the earth. And we pour to those who remained on the continent of Africa, those who helped build great cities on the continent that thrived for thousands of years, Ashe. We pour libations to the Ma'afa, Ashe, and the Middle Passage, Ashe, the great Black Holocaust, Ashe, and to the millions of lives that were lost, Ashe. But we pour to those who endured and those who survived the Middle Passage, Ashe. Those who came over to the New World, and we pour to the New World, North America, Central America, South America, and the Caribbean, Ashe. And family, we pour to the kings and queens of these new nations, Ashe, and these kingdoms, the Mayas, the Incas, Ashe. And we pour libations to the freedom fighters of these nations, Ashe. Marcus Garvey, Ashe. Toussaint Louverture, Ashe. Harriet Tubman, Ashe. Ida B. Wells, Ashe. And we pour affirmations to the institutions, Ashe. Like the HBCUs, Ashe. Sankofa Freedom Academy Charter School, Ashe, and the Freedom School Movement, Ashe. And we pour to the scholars and those who are learning about our history in order for us to move forward into the future, Ashe. And we pour to our personal ancestors. May we hold them in our hearts, Ashe. And family, we pour to the babies and the babies' babies, those who are going to complete our circle, Ashe. And to our ancestors, those who are going to come in, the babies' babies who are going to complete our circle, but also to our ancestors in hopes that they accept this libation, Ashe. Ashe. And so, family, the principle of the month is, and that means, yes, the principle of the month is Kuumba, and that means creativity. Yes, and family, it is so exciting to be celebrating such a creative principle, and because there's so much about Kuumba that is to be celebrated, not just the fun and exciting things, but also the things that make you have to stop and think. And that's where Kuumba is so powerful. The fact that in order to create, we sometimes have to take a minute and think about what we have to create. And sometimes it's about messing up and falling and starting over. And sometimes things that were created that have lasted for generations and sometimes centuries, they weren't like they are now. They were created and there was some mess up along the way and they had to be recreated. And that's the beauty of Kuumba. It's not always perfect and sometimes it has to be redone. And sometimes it may not get redone and we just have to settle for what it is. And so that we just create more and more and more. And that reminds me of a particular art that has been with us since the cradle of civilization, and that is science. And science is a art, and science is such an example of Kuumba because it takes trial and error, and it takes thinking, it takes creating. And so that's what we're going to learn about today in our read aloud. And so we heard about Katherine Johnson and we heard about all these different scientists. But I want you guys to learn about the science in you, the scientist in you, the Kuumba master in you. And so we're going to learn about that in our read aloud today. And I want you to enjoy this read aloud, and we're going to talk more about it on the other side. But let's get ready for read aloud, and here it goes.
Ada Twist, Scientist, by Andrea Beattie, illustrated by David Roberts. Ada Marie, said not a word till the day she turned three. She bounced in her crib and looked all around, observing the world but not making a sound. She learned how to climb and made her big break with a trail of chaos left in her wake. She ran through the day chasing each sound in sight and didn't slow down till she conked out at night. Her parents were frazzled but tried not to freak as Ada grew bigger and still did not speak. Clearly young Ada, with lots in her head, would have something to say when it ought to be said. That's just what happened when Ada turned three. She tore through the house on a fact-finding spree and climbed up the clock just as high as she could. Her parents yelled stop, as all good parents would. Ada's chin quivered, but she did not cry. She took a deep breath and she simply asked, why? Why does it tick and why does it talk? And why don't we call it a granddaughter clock? Why are there pointy things stuck to a rose? And why are there hairs up inside of our nose? She started with why and then what, how, and when. By bedtime, she came back to why once again. She drifted to sleep as her day's parents smiled at the curious thoughts of a curious child who wanted to know what the world was about. They kissed her and whispered, you'll figure it out. Her parents kept up with their high-flying kid whose questions and chaos both grew as she did. Even Miss Greer found her hands were quite full when young Ada's chaos wreaked havoc at school. But this much was clear about Miss Ada Twist. She had all the traits of a great scientist. Ada was busy that first day of spring, testing the sounds that the mockingbirds sing. When a horrible stench whacked her right in her nose, a pungent aroma that curled up her toes. Zowie, said Ada, which got her to thinking, which is the source of that terrible stinking? How does a nose know there's something to smell? And does it still stink if there's no nose to tell? She rattled off questions and tapped on her chin. She'd start at the start where she ought to begin. A mystery, a riddle, a puzzle, a quest. This was the moment that Ada loved best. Ada did research to learn all she could of smelling and smells, both the stinky and good. One hypothesis Ada thought could be true: the terrible stink came from Dad's cabbage stew. She tested and tested, but soon Ada knew it was time to come up with hypothesis two. Then Zowie, the stink struck again, just like that. Hypothesis two, it's caused by the cat. The cat couldn't make such a stink on its own. It needed perfume or some fancy cologne. So young Ada tested. The test was a flop. It started again, but her parents yelled stop. Ada Marie, Ada Marie, to the thinking chair now, by the time we count three. Enough, said her mother. That's it, said her dad. Her parents were frustrated, frazzled, and mad. Why, Ada questioned. Her mother said no. What, Ada queried. Her father said go. You've ruined our supper. You've made the cat stink. Enough with your questions. Now sit there and think. She looked at her parents. Her heart turned to goo. Poor Ada Twist didn't know what to do. She sat all alone by herself in the hall, and Ada once more could say nothing at all. And so Ada sat, and she sat, and she sat, and she thought about science and stew and the cat, and how her experiments made such a big mess. Does it have to be so? Is that part of success? Are messes a problem? And while she was thinking, what was the source of that terrible stinking? Ada Marie did what scientists do. She asked a small question, and then she asked two. And each of those led her to three questions more, and some of those questions resulted in four. As Ada got thinking, she really dug in. She scribbled her questions and tapped on her chin. She started at why, and then what, how, and when. At the end of the hall, she reached why once again. Her parents calmed down and they came back to talk. They looked at the hallway and just had to gawk. No patch of bare paint could be seen on the wall. The thinking chair now was a great thinking wall. They watched their young daughter and sigh as they did. What would they do with this curious kid who wanted to know what the world was about? They smiled and whispered, "We'll figure it out." And that's what they did, because that's what you do when your kid has a passion and heart that is true. They remade their world. Now they're all in the act of helping young Ada sort fiction from fact. She asked lots of questions. How could she resist? It's all in the heart of a young scientist. And as for that smell, what can Ada Twist do but learn all she can with her friends in grade two? Will they discover the stink that curls toes? Well, that is the question. And someday, who knows?
Yes, yes. And I hope you guys love that story. I love this story. This is one of my daughter's favorite books. Ada Twist, Scientist. Written by Andrea Beatty and illustrated by David Roberts. I love the illustrations in the story. But I love how creative our writer was to make it into rhymes, make this into a poem about a scientist, a young scientist. And we got to think about how that's Kuumba. Ada wanted to ask questions, and she wanted to investigate and think, and she was curious, and she wanted to create something, not necessarily something physical, but she wanted to create answers, solutions. She had a question about what smelled funny, and she went and asked a lot of questions in order to find the answers. And that family is Kuumba. And I really wanted to use science today to demonstrate how broad Kuumba can be, how big Kuumba can be. It goes so much further than drawing and painting, which are all great things that we need in our world. But when we take it further to find solutions, like scientists right now are scrambling to find solutions for this virus, right? And in the past, scientists have scrambled and thought and built and created solutions for so many things in this world. And I just wanted to inspire some of you to think about maybe you might want to be a scientist when you get older. And there are so many scientists in our community, and it is something to appreciate. And that is something that we need to apply to Kuumba. And I hope that you guys understand that and found that when we were listening to our story, Ada Twist Scientist by Andrea Beatty. And that makes me think of the word of the day. The word of the day, family, is curious. Yes, family, the word of the day, once again, is curious. Ada was a curious young lady. She was a curious sister since the day she was born. She asked questions like why, and then why turned into how and what and when. And so she was so curious to find solutions to things. And so, family, what are you curious about? Yesterday we had recess with the fourth grade, and Brother Issa asked such a great question about what did scholars know about this virus that's going around. And we heard such great answers, and that made me curious. It made me want to research more. Brother Issa asked questions about this virus, and so many of us are curious about what is going on. But family, what is it that you're curious about? What are you curious about what's going on today? What are you curious about what's going on in your life? What are you curious about the world? You know, my daughters have so many curiosities. They want to ask questions about the universe. They love asking questions about animals. They love asking questions about the ocean. And so I want to know what it is that you guys are curious about. Again, family, the word of the day is curious.
Keep having
conversations about Kuumba and the many different aspects of Kuumba, the writing, the art, the painting, the drawing, the music, and the science. So because we're talking about creating things and creating things that are good for us, good for our community, and good for the world. I'm excited about the principle of the month, Kuumba, and the word of the day is curious. And so aren't you curious about who I'm recognizing today? Okay, so let's get to that. I have a recognition. I said I have a recognition. And so first, family, I would like to recognize Riley Lynn Benjamin. Good morning, she says. The word of the day is unique. I really enjoyed the presentation and from the staff, and it was really nice, and it made me smile. And so that was our goal, and I shout out all the facilitators and staff that came together and brought their Kuumba to make scholars smile. Thank you for that, staff. And thank you, Riley Lynn Benjamin, for commenting on that. And so, yes, we're talking about the word of the day yesterday, which was unique. And the artist Powell kids say, Nakai and Zori say, the word of the day is unique. Everyone is unique in their own way. Nakai and Zori have heard music from Celia Cruz. Rie y Llora is my favorite song to play for them. That is a great song. I love Rie y Llora from Celia Cruz. Thank you so much from the artist Powell family. I appreciate that you're loving that music from Celia Cruz. Aria Gordon and mom say, we are all unique in some kind of way. And greetings from Aria Gordon and mom. So greetings to you. Yes, we are unique in our own way. Soraya Burnett says, the word of the day is unique, and I am unique when I dance, sing, flip, and do splits. Also, she says, I like Minute by Minute. I'm glad you liked it, and I appreciate that you see that you are unique when you do the things that you love. And that's what it's all about, being unique in your own way and loving it and being proud of it. Yolanda Whitehead says, the word of the day is unique. We are all unique in different ways. Yes, we are. Thank you for that, Yolanda. Mama Dana says, I love this. I am dancing around my kitchen, and Minute by Minute was powerful. I'm glad that I was able to do something to make you dance around your kitchen, Mama Dana. I'm going to keep playing different types of music, so be on the lookout for that. Thank you, Mama Dana, for your comment. Michaela's mom says, this was beautiful. You guys are doing such an awesome job. Let's keep the positivity going, from Michaela's mom. Good morning, Michaela. I'm from Michaela. Michaela says, I'm unique in my own way because I dare to be different. That is a beautiful thing. Daring to be different, being courageous, to just love yourself and be yourself. And that is unique. So thank you for that. And thank you for your kind comments, Michaela's mom. We are trying our best. And we love parents like you who keep the positivity going as well. The Bowen sisters say, good morning. The word of the day is unique. This time that we are having is unique. Wow, it really is. Meaning that no one else has ever done this before, like our ancestors before us. We are trailblazing. Like our ancestors before us, we are trailblazing a new and unique way of learning and coming together. That is so deep from the Bowen sisters. Absolutely. This is a time, although there have been pandemics in the past and we've had to be quarantined in the past, it's unlike any other time. We have different ways of communication now. We have a lot more people in the world. We have different technologies. And so we are navigating through something that has never been navigated through before. And you put it in such a deep way. And I appreciate the Bowen sisters for making that comment. Ms. Comfort Bowens as well. Thank you for that. Rodney Tanksley says, good morning. The word of the day is unique. We are all unique. That's what makes us different from everybody else. And I love the presentation at the end. I so thank you for that, brother. These facilitators really came together and they continue to come together for you, for all of you scholars. And I so appreciate you guys appreciating that. Thank you for that, Rodney Tinsley. Isaiah Thomas says, good morning. I think my family is unique. Yes, your family is unique. And I love your family, Brother Isaiah. So thank you for your comment. You are unique as well. Domaine Austin says, I am unique in my own way when I play my game. Yep, and that's how you win, by being unique, right? So good job, Domaine. Thank you for that. My Asia Gonzalez Williams says, the word unique means to be that if you are unique. You are different than anybody else, than everybody else, and that you have something no one else can have. Absolutely. We all have something that no one else can have. And so you have to be proud of that. Thank you for that, My Asia. Randy Jameson says, the word of the day is unique. Sankofa is unique because all the students and teachers have different unique traits. Absolutely. And that's what makes us such a special school, right? Because we are unique. Thank you for that, Randy. Asia Nay Broda says, the word of the day is unique. And I miss you guys. We miss you too, Asia Nay. And we're going to see each other very soon. Anaya Howard says, good morning. The word of the day is unique. And when I think of unique, I think of everybody being one of a kind in their own way. Yes, being one of a kind, being who you are, no matter what, and being proud of that. Thank you for that, Anaya. London Hightower, I'm unique. I don't know how just yet, but I know I'm unique. That is such a great comment. You don't know how, but you know that you're unique. And you're still, it takes courage to say something like that, really, if you think about it, because you're still growing, you're still learning a lot about yourself. But as long as you know that you are unique and you are your own self, that's a great start. So thank you for that comment, London. Kevin Hunter says, the word of the day is unique, and I am unique at football. Again, this is how we win games, by being unique, being yourself. So thank you for that, Kevin, and I'm glad you recognize that. Munir Riggin says, the word of the day is unique, and I am unique because I have my own style. You certainly do, brother, and I love that about you. So yes, you are unique, Munir. And congratulations on your certificate, brother. Good job. And so that was Munir. And Sister Ebony, shout out to Sister Ebony, says, beautiful. And I think she was referring to the minute by minute. It was powerful. And I appreciate the facilitators for doing that. And I love Mama Sabrina saying, I feel good about my brothers and sisters around me. And then Sister Joy comes in and says, I feel goodness all around me. I really love the passion that they all put into that. Even Brother Muhammadu, who I got a little secret, you know, he gets nervous in front of talking in front of people. He's like, because I talk with good. And I so appreciated that. And I love seeing Alaysia with Brother Martique doing their part. And little Caleb seeing brothers and sisters. And so I really, truly loved the Kuumba that the facilitators and staff brought to it. And I thank all of you for being a part of it. But that was my recognitions for today. But I have a birthday to celebrate, family. And we have one birthday today, May 5th, and that is Khadija Khan. And so Khadija celebrates a birthday today. She's the only person, and if I'm missing anybody again, please comment down below. But today we celebrate Khadija, and so I hope she is watching. And if you are, please comment down below. But I'm going to have Stevie sing to you one time real quick. Sing it, Stevie. And I love doing that, and I hope you enjoy your day, Khadija, and enjoy your week. And family, if there are any other birthday shout-outs, please let me know, and I will make sure I do that. And so, family, as you noticed, in the beginning of this video, in the beginning of Morning Circle, I showed some scholars showing their Kuumba, and I'm encouraging scholars to send more pictures of them showing Kuumba and showing your uniqueness and showing your curiosity. And also don't forget, please send pictures. I want to have pictures by Wednesday, tomorrow, so that I could have pictures of moms, so that I could have that presented by Friday. Because Sunday is Mother's Day, and I really want to honor our moms. So be on the lookout for that. But please send pictures of you and your moms so that I can represent them and present them on Friday. Yay, Bo. Yay, Bo. And so for our closing thoughts, our closing remarks, family, again, the word of the day is curious. And I want you, again, to comment down below and let me know what it is that you are curious about. And I so appreciate Miss Bowens and the Bowens family for making the comment that they did, and the comments that many of you have been kind of reiterating, that we are at a very different time, a very unique time, and that makes us curious. And the beautiful thing, and this is difficult, it's a difficult time, but we have to find the beauty in some of these difficult times. And shout out to Sister Kia, who made this comment yesterday about finding the goodness of what this is all about, bringing families together and doing things that we wouldn't typically do when we are working or going to school. But one of the beautiful things about this difficult time is that it sparks curiosity. It makes us think more. It makes us research more. It pushes us to be more creative, scientifically, artistically, in so many different ways. And so we have to think about that. Some of us worry about this COVID-19. Some of us get anxious about being inside and not going out a lot. But we have to think of the beauty that it is pushing us to create. We become more curious about how to find cures. We get more curious of how to entertain ourselves in more positive ways. We become curious about how we can create different things to make us feel better during a time where we are forced to not feel so great. And so I want us to think about that. What is it that you are curious about? And what is it that you are creating to make this situation better? Let's think about that during our moment of silence. And the moment of silence begins now. I'm going to take a deep breath. And so, family, let's have a very productive day. Make sure that you are doing your work and turning in your work. Let's put our curiosity on pause for a moment and do our work and show your facilitators what is it that you already know, and that's your work. Yay, Bo. Make sure that you are signing into sfacs.us. You are clicking on the cyber program lowest school link, and you are signing into our attendance tracker, and then you're getting into work. We want to make sure that we are being as productive as possible. Yay, Bo. So, family, enjoy the rest of your day. Have a great and safe day. I will see you again tomorrow. Peace. I love you. Bye-bye.